Good evening, friends. This is time for the review of December 18th, 2020. We would leave the trade plan to another video because I would like to see how the S&P 500 closes before I get on with Monday's trade plan. For the moment, you know, if you like our videos, if you want notifications, hit the like button, hit on subscribe, share the video in your groups and with your friends and family. So the other point is, if you want research, the taste of which you keep getting on my Facebook group, etc., you should try to use the join button, the silver and gold and diamond, and benefit from research we do on such volatile days. And you would recall yesterday I had said that there are signs of a turning point of the Nifty, and today we gapped up and went screaming down first, but the market, as usual, came back. So, you know, the best days in the market are when you trade and you are successful on both sides. So let's get started with what happened on the Nifty. As you all know, we had 13,700 December 24th puts. So the market went screaming down, and we made about 25 bucks on a put, which was about 90 rupees. So that felt good. See, generally I have larger than usual volumes, so I need to make very small number of points for a decent profit. After that, the Nifty, after this screaming down, it went into sideways. And, it wasn't really clear where is it headed. So a couple of trades which really were kind of break-even trades. At this point, what happened was, let me show you why I took profits off at this zone. I was watching the Bank Nifty like I do all the time. Now, on the Bank Nifty, what started to happen was that, as I always say in my program, look to the left. The Bank Nifty had almost reached this zone. So immediately I knew that banks could reverse from here. If the banks reverse, so does the Nifty. So this was the point where I took off my puts on the Nifty. And like I said, after some, couple of here and there type trades, finally we bought the Bank Nifty 30,000. 800 call at about this sort of zone. Why? Because where were the shorts? The shorts were in the Bank Nifty. If the market is refusing to go down, it was clear that we were not breaking 13,700. Where would the short covering come? The short covering also would be in the Bank Nifty. Bank Nifty, which was down like 350 points, went screaming up, and somewhere here we took our money off, and after that the Bank Nifty came off a bit. So we got two decent trades, a couple of break-even style trades, and that is trading. As long as you negotiated today's day well, I think you can have a good weekend. Now, what do we expect for next week? More of the same. At least on Bank Nifty, we are in a very, very tight range. Today, we went to the lower end of the range. This is the higher end of the range. So same story. Volatility. If you go down to the lower end of the range, you buy. At the higher end of the range, maybe you try to sell. So that remains the story on the Bank Nifty. Still, let's see where S&P 500 closes for the day. On the Nifty, again, the range is developing, but the Nifty is stronger than the Bank Nifty. So, my sense would be that Nifty is likely to find support at 13,700 on declines. So, anytime we get in the 680-700 band, you want to buy into the Nifty for a tradable upside. See, people want a view, 14,500 or 12,500. You know, these questions are not business-like. The business-like question is, how do I make money on the next trading session? So stop obsessing over where the next large move is and play for small moves, because that is what the market is giving you right now. We went home with ICICI Bank basically because the Bank Nifty was recovering. And like I had said yesterday, this is the point at which ICICI Bank gained strength, and we took this home, and let's see what happens on Monday. The issue is that markets are very volatile. They are gapping against you. So you don't want to, you know, overstay your welcome on BTSD. Hence, you did only one instead of two. But overall, I would think that till the market takes a direction which could be below 13,400, 450 or above, I would say, you know, 13,800, expect a rangy type move, particularly on the Bank Nifty. You can easily have a 500-600 point range, and that's a good enough range to do business in. If you are waiting for those plunges to buy into, if you are trying to play trend in a market that is sideways, you are asking for trouble. So that should be the review for the day. We didn't have too many calls for today, and I think a couple that I have forgotten to discuss. One was HUL. Unilever. Now, Hindustan Unilever. Started well above this congestion and initially did very well, but the market obviously was extremely volatile, and hence it came off and then again went up. So that trade was kind of a break-even style trade. We also took TCS. Why? Because tech had tailwind, at least in the early part of the day. Now, you know, tech and banks, they generally move against each other. You had TCS, and TCS continued to rise even as the market fell. So again, TCS, we bought above this congestion and It did well for a while and we got out somewhere here. But end of day, it collapsed. So that is what we are dealing with. So hence, you know, keep your expectations low and try to take as much as you are able to get on smaller moves. The issue is that people get attuned to booking a certain amount of profit or percentage of profit. You have to adjust expectations according to the market. Otherwise, the market will quickly take back what it has given you. Particularly on options trading, since the momentum is low, you know, time is really playing out against you. The volatility has gone down. So be very careful that you have to do things at turning points and not just randomly, because price movement will not bail you out. So for all of these issues, use our join buttons on the YouTube channel Silver, Gold, Diamond. And for the rest, subscribe, like, and share to keep on getting this great content. I think by Monday, I should have the training channel ready, hopefully. And you will start to see our charting posts out there. I will give you all a shout out, and you can, you know, start to register for that trading channel. All you will have to give is tell us what webinar or which period you were our client, and that should be enough to let you in. And you know the email and WhatsApp. WhatsApp is 9871066337, and email at ashwani_gujral@yahoo.com. That is ashwani_gujral. This is also given in the description. That should be it. Have a good weekend. Party hard and get ready for Monday.